is not of me. At the cross he paid to take my place, and there's nothing left for me to do. I've been freed by you, that I might know you and love you. Identity supplied by the Savior who died for me.
God, I'm worried that it's temporary, and going back to who I was is an idea that scares me. So I battle hard, attempting to prove I can refuse all the temptations that I used to use as a surrogate Messiah to show that I was valuable to somebody. How else would I know? But if my effort is the newfound mediator, what will happen when I find it isn't enough either? I bet I sit in despair and huddle up inside the closet locked under the stairs, hoping there I can avoid all the stares and keep from recognizing I invited this here. Perseverance is provided by his grace alone, accessible through faith alone. If I trust him enough to give eternity, why would I think anything would be different on earth then?
I fight now to live my life out of what he's done for me, 'cause it's not of me. At the cross he paid to take my place, and there's nothing left for me to do. I've been freed by you, that I might know you and love you. Identity supplied by the Savior who died for me.
I don't wanna hide inside a story that I author. I know the limitations of the words I have to offer. My God split the calendar to draw me to his love and introduce me to a world of possibilities. The cross is solid proof that I am loved, accepted. His blood has paid the price. I live my life indebted. I can't invent my own significance with set design. I have to trust lines written by divine direction. Whose approval am I seeking? Is it me? Moving constantly so I can prove I'm really free? In the stillness and the quiet, I can just abide and rest in full assurance I've been justified. My blood identifies his peace, the mark within, the evidence that he has made an end to all my sin. While the verbiage might terrify, still I'm liberated fully. The noun has been killed.
I fight now to live my life out of what he's done for me, 'cause it's not of me. At the cross he paid to take my place, and there's nothing left for me to do. I've been freed by you, that I might know you and love you. Identity supplied by the Savior who died for me.
I push hard to convince myself
that I'm nothing like the person that I used to be.
Used to be.
Always checking the reflection in the glass. I'm covered with the clippings from my criminal past. The serial offender takes a second to remember. Hoping 7 pounds purchases forgiveness. If I'm the opposite, there's positive accomplishment. Cancel out the negative I did then? No. That reduced Christ's sacrifice is self-help. I can turn my life around and I'll earn hell. Action is only symptomatic of disease. If I manage my behavior
or I modify my deeds,
that doesn't alter my identity.
'Cause of depravity, the rebirth of the spirit is the remedy.
In the shadow of the glorious cross
is where I made a new creation, reconciled to God.
Christ finished it and I don't have to add to it.
Instead of making something of myself, I'll let my dad do it.
Try pirating what is already mine,
but reverence on the outside is no certain sign.
Subtle shifting of the order of events,
a belief that I can please him with the bleeding I present.
But if a bloody goat was good enough to cleanse,
there'd have been no crucifixion. My righteousness offends him.
That's why I'm grateful that the Savior has been sent. I just need to constantly repent of attempts now to merit what my merciful Messiah's massacre meant, and just live in